Liberal Senator for New South Wales, Concetta Fierravanti-Wells now. Good to catch up with you again, Connie. First up, your take on the rise of Dominic Perrottet. How can you be world-wise enough and experienced enough politically to be the Premier of the largest state in the country at 39 years of age?
Well, firstly, Chris, good to be with you. Can I just congratulate Dominic Perrottet on his election as Premier? I've supported Dom for many years, coming as we both do from the Conservative side of the party. So, as he has indicated, he's had experience across the board in various areas. And so I wish him and his team all the very, very best, particularly as they as we move towards coming out of lockdown.
Yeah, do you think we'll see a change in tone? As you say, he's a Conservative Premier, but he's worked hand in glove with a moderate Premier until now. In fact, the past two moderate Premiers, I suppose. Do you think he will shift the direction of the New South Wales government to the right to a large degree?
Look, I think that Dominic has received overwhelming support from both his Conservative and moderate colleagues. Dom is certainly, as a young man of family and faith, reflective, I think, of many millions of people in the community who share his values and beliefs. And I think that his values are reflective of much of the silent majority in this country. And so, Chris, we bring different experience, we bring different beliefs, we bring our own values and beliefs to our political jobs. And I've always found that people may not always agree with you, but they'll respect you more if you're prepared to stand up for what you believe in.
Yeah, now I just want to bring to everybody's attention the chapter you've written in the book Australia Tomorrow, edited by Jake Thrupp, who's a producer for Alan Jones. And your chapter focused on what's wrong with the Liberal Party. Here's the cover of the book. It's a ripping read, nearly 40 essays from various contributors. And you, Senator, say that the Liberal Party has moved too far to the left. Now, one of the issues you highlight is debt and expenditure. That's sort of been precipitated mainly by the pandemic, I suppose. But in what other ways do you believe the Liberal Party has moved too far to the left?
Well, I think when you... In my essay, Chris, what I sought to do was look at the values and beliefs that of the Liberal Party as set out in the federal constitution. What I did is I looked across a whole range of different issues and just to see where we have moved away from those values. Now, in any political party, and most especially in the Liberal Party, there are a divergence of views. But when Menzies set up the Liberal Party, he set up a party that both had a moderate wing and a conservative wing. And I think what is very important is that there be that appropriate balance. And we know that during the Howard years, and you yourself have worked in the political sphere, and you've seen that it's very important to find that appropriate balance. And when you do move too far to one side or too far from the other, then you do lose that balance. And what
sorry to interrupt, but let's just have some specific issues. I think debt's easy to understand. A lot of people are concerned at the amazing amount of expenditure and debt we're seeing from coalition governments in response to the pandemic. I suppose another one would be climate policy. Do you think that the coalition has gone too far on net zero?
I do. When you start looking at climate issues, you start looking at woke, you start looking at cancel culture, you start looking at some of the things that are now being are happening, you start to wonder, and I know that as I speak to hundreds and hundreds of people in the Liberal Party, as I have over recent months, they are concerned that values and beliefs that they hold dear have not been trashed under a Labor government, but have been trashed under a Liberal government that they helped to elect.
Great to talk to you, Connie. I appreciate it.
Thanks very much, Chris.